And that's good. And you're burning your face. It's pretty hot. Yeah, I'm really glad that we did this today.
Hello, this is Kyle Byron, the Toronto nutritionist, and today I'm going to show you how to make a cream of broccoli soup with some chicken. Now for portions, I've told you this before, I think. You basically just want your meat portion to be outnumbered by your vegetables by about 4 to 1 or 3 to 1. So I've got this much meat, it's like maybe 5 portions, and then I have all this vegetables. So in terms of having vegetables, we're good to go. I might even add a little bit more protein to my portion once it's made, but all this chicken is just gonna go in the soup. All right, so there's got some leeks I've already prepared. I have another video about how to prep leeks, and you can watch that. Just to take you through it quickly, first I'm gonna throw the chicken in the oven, then I start sauteing some of this stuff, then we do the broccoli, then we add some of the cheese and the cream, and we use the hand blender, and we can use the Vitamix as well. All right, so sit tight, and here we go. Okay, so first I'm gonna throw the chicken in the oven. I've got the oven preheated to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. And this is a baking dish. I don't like using, you know, aluminums in the kitchen. So sometimes I'll use cast iron for the chicken, but I find lately my cast iron chickens have been really dry. So I'm just gonna bake this. Hands are now contaminated. So I'll cook it at 425 for about like 10 minutes and I'll drop it down to like 350 and then I'll just check on it, bring it up to 165 and then that's good. All right, got a timer just to remind me. All right, so next we're gonna get into the vegetables. The recipe is going to be in the comments below, so you don't have to memorize this or watch the whole video. But first I'm going to get some oil going in this. I got a really big pot over there. In fact, I don't even know if it's big enough. I hope so. So we're going to get some oil going in there, and then in is going to go the celery, the garlic, and we're going to get some of that sauteing. So just stand by and watch and learn, I guess. This is the good stuff. I only use the good olive oil. I mean, it's kind of more expensive, but the flavor is much better. Since this soup is gonna get like blended up, I don't have to make these like fancy chopped up. I can throw them in the Vitamix. So I'll just put them into pieces like that. And this will just save time. Okay, it says I'm supposed to use, for the double batch, 8 cloves of garlic. I'm not so sure I'm gonna do that much. What do you think, honey?
Maybe not 8.
Alright, so we won't do 8.
That seems aggressive.
And these are pretty huge cloves. I'm just gonna put in... It's kind of just like 8 regular ones anyway, so maybe we just went there. When you're using large amounts of garlic, I've got a video on how to like prep it really fast in my kitchen hacks. Those are my leeks that I chopped, and I'm just gonna make them into smaller pieces there.
least some of them. So I'm supposed to add a bit of water into there as well. It says a few tablespoons. There we go.
Where'd you get this recipe?
I don't know. So immediately that smells quite nice. I have no idea where I got this recipe.
How long have you been using it?
10 years. All right, in the last few minutes, the chicken timer went. So I brought it down from 425 Fahrenheit down to about 350, and I set the timer for 14 or 15 minutes. So that chicken is fine. You can see the steam coming out of there. That's the leeks and the celery and the garlic. Now we gotta get this going. So if you've watched any of my broccoli videos, you know that you just kind of snap that off. My compost is overflowing right now. I always put my compost beside me so I don't have to keep turning around and going under the sink when I'm batch cooking. This is a lot of broccoli. And you always just hope that your pot's big enough. If it's not, we'll split it into two pots. When that timer goes, that 4 minutes, all this has to be in there. So I'm kind of behind the eight ball, and I'm not even sure what I'm doing. But that's cooking. Right. Now, the stems are a lot harder than the florets. So this recipe tells you to separate those things, because we're going to cook the stalks for a little bit longer, like every good broccoli chef knows to do that, because the stems take longer to cook, so you put them in first. Did this broccoli get washed? Make sure you wash the broccoli. This stuff is filthy, which is, I mean, we bought it off of a farmer's market, and so they don't always clean the broccoli like they do in the grocery store. Yes, food is grown in dirt. Sometimes, if I just throw the stalks out, outtakes. All right. Time to wash some veggies. All right, we're gonna go off camera for a little bit, and I'm gonna prep this, wash the potatoes. The parsley's gonna go in soon as well. Ready? Cut. Okay, so stir that a few times. You got your leeks in there, and I got about 1 minute before that's done. And then the stalks are going to go in. And I might chop them up more than that, but remember, we're just going to blend the soup up anyway. So you can throw in these big gnarly pieces and just blend them up when they're softer. That's fine. I'm going to get some parsley here. I need 1 cup chopped. So I'm going to wash this and then chop. Now, when you're at home and you're cooking, you don't have to be as frantic as I am. I just get like that when I cook, because I'm always trying to get it done fast, like maybe you are as well. But you don't have to. You can take your time and all that. There. That's about a cup. That's half a cup smashed in there. Right. That broccoli's clean, all that, haven't washed that yet. I'm gonna just set that aside for later. Lots of parsley, give you that fresh taste. Get in there. Right. That's our leeks. Timer off. So this consistency should be, it should be pretty darn soft here at this point. And you don't want it sticking to the bottom. I was playing with fire there, and some of it was sticking a little bit. You can just put some water in there and get that off of there. According to the recipe, that's done. So I'm just gonna follow the recipe and carry on. So now it says, add the water. So this recipe calls for a lot of water because we're gonna do the broccoli. Is add the water and bring to a boil. So I'm gonna do that first before I add the stems. I almost screwed that up. Water first, bring it up to a boil. and then the broccoli's going in. So this is gonna be like, this is gonna be like 5 or 10 minutes before that does anything. So now I have time to sort of tidy this up. I'm gonna wash all this and wash my potatoes, and then when that comes up to boil, all that's gonna go in there, okay? All right, cut. Okay, now we're gonna start to cook the broccoli. Remember, we separated the broccoli into the hard, hard stems. These have to cook longer. They go in first, and the broccoli florets. For saving time, I mean for cook time, like if you cut these up just a little bit, they will cook a little bit faster. By the way, I just checked the chicken. It's not even close to being done yet. So that's good. And I also washed the potatoes, and you saw me do the parsley already. The recipe calls for... That was for the chicken. So just put another 10 minutes on there. The potatoes call for 1 fist. We're doing a double batch, so I have 2 fists of potatoes. And again, I can just cut those in half so they cook a little bit faster. And behind me, you should see, hopefully steam starts to fire out of that pot, as I know it's almost about to boil. So that's all gonna go in, plus our parsley. See a little bit of steam going out of there, so I'm going for it. Oh yeah, it's raging. It's raging in there. It's good. Alright. Put that lid back on, and now we wait. We're gonna wait 10 minutes. And then we're gonna add half the broccoli heads. So I'll talk to you in 10 minutes, although for you, it'll just be like a few seconds, and that's because I will edit this 10 minutes out. Ready? Cut. All right, so while I'm waiting for those things to boil, I'm just gonna tidy up a little bit, and you might be wondering why I use this recipe. Well, it's delicious. The portions are exactly right, like for grams of fat per serving, it's like less than 10. The carbohydrates are low, even though there's a few potatoes in there. And of course, we got the chicken in there. So portions are great, it tastes great, and we can freeze a bunch of it, okay? So I think you should always have a couple of things in the freezer, like a chili or like a soup, like that has all the components. So you can just come home and heat that up on a busy night. We're gonna be getting into the sour cream and the cheese soon. Another reason why it's good to have stockpiled foods is if, let's say you have a baby or something and you don't have a lot of energy anymore. So before your baby's born, if you spend like a couple weekends and just like stockpile up your fridge with soups just like this and chilies and all that, that will really come in handy. Or if you're starting a new job and you think it's going to be really busy for the first month or it's year end or whatever. It's funny how you eat better when you're prepared with healthy food. Okay, so in the recipe it says 30 grams of cheese, and the cheese that I bought doesn't have a label on it that's going to help me decipher that. So I got on my food scale, and I've never used it. Been a nutritionist for 11 years, and I don't have people weigh their food. There's a lot of other ways to eat. So this is 134 grams. I need 60 grams. So if I cut this in half, it'll just be a little over 60. So food scale came in handy right there. Thank you, food scale. Cut. All right, this stuff is supposed to be soft before half of this stuff goes in. It's pretty much there, and I'm following the directions that, and I've made this recipe a bunch of times, so I should be able to trust that. Now it says half of these go in the main pot, and then you get a little side pot going here, and you're gonna steam the rest of the heads. So I just have like a little bit of water in there, so it just comes up to heat really fast. I washed all this before. Yield. Try and press some of that down into that hot stuff. Get it in there. Try and sink it all down into the hot water there. And I'm going to put a lid on that. My side pot's not boiling yet. And I found some stems in the bottom of there, so the stems gotta go in there first. But anyways, so now we're just starting to cook up the broccoli. And when that's done, we're gonna use the cheese and the sour cream and the blender, and then it'll be done. Chicken is still cooking, by the way. Okay. All right, we're almost done. Now, I've separated the broccoli cooking into two separate pots, and that's fine. And then the timing can be thrown off. You know, if you just start to get extra broccoli piling up, just put it into a bowl and it's cooked. You know, the potato is also a good marker in there. That potato wasn't actually done, so I know I had to just sort of let that cook for a bit longer. As soon as that's done, cheese goes in, salt goes in, sour cream goes in, and then we blend it up. And then you can chop up the chicken and put it in there as well, or you can have the chicken on the side. The chicken is still not done, by the way. It went in, it was pretty cold when it went in, so it takes a long time to cook. I was thinking about the nutrition of this meal. Like, when you cook vegetables that long, like some of that broccoli now have been in there for like 15 minutes, yeah, you are going to lose some of the micronutrition, the vitamins and the antioxidants. What are you going to do? Just eat raw all the time? Yeah, I mean, you could, that'd be really good for you, but I don't sweat that stuff. I'm going to have a multivitamin if I'm having a meal like that where I know some of the micronutrients have been lost and I can catch up that way. Or, you know, I just eat a lot of fruit as well and a lot of vegetables generally. So any blood work I've ever done, my micronutrition is fine. But yes, when you're cooking something for this long, you will lose some of the micronutrients. All right. This is my side pot. That's taking forever. Don't do what I just did to try and touch things with your finger like that. I knew that that wasn't going to be hot, but... All right, the next step in the recipe is to add these ingredients, as I mentioned. Here comes the cheese that I previously weighed out to the exact portion. This is salt that the other day I put in a grinder. Soups need a lot of salt before they taste good. This recipe calls for 1 cup of sour cream. I'm a bit hesitant to do that. I might just try half a cup. But you know what? No, I'm gonna follow the recipe. I'm going for it. What percentage is this? 6%? Alright. That's almost a cup. There we go. Salt, I need some pepper in here. And then we're gonna get the hand blender out. Now, I have done this where I've scooped it all out and put it in the Vitamix and then back. Hand blender is probably easier. This has to be inserted before you press on, or else, yeah, it's like you're burning your face. So you insert it and then go. I don't like this hand blender. It has this lock thing and I gotta press that every time. All right, personal preference. I could liquefy that until it's liquefied, or I could leave it more chunky. Just again, personal preference. This is the rest of the broccoli. I gotta get that in there. And then we're pretty much done. All right. All the ingredients are in, we cooked them down, we blended it up with a hand blender, and now I've got some Tupperware out and a ladle, and it's just gonna get stored in the freezer. You have to bring it down to room temperature or close to before you put it in the freezer, or else putting these boiling hot things will bring your freezer up to like hot temperature and then everything in your freezer spoils. So let this stuff cool off a little bit, and to help it cool off faster, you can do these little thin layers. And that increases the surface area, and that'll allow it to cool faster. I'm gonna cut up the chicken, and I'm gonna sprinkle it into each of these containers. Although I'm getting kinda hungry, I might have some now.
Why are you gonna cut up the chicken into those layers?
I'm gonna cut up the chicken into tiny pieces because that's how chicken is in soups. It's in tiny pieces. And if I need any more protein, I can have some more, but the ratio of protein to vegetables here is pretty good, as we discussed earlier. I can't cut up the chicken yet though because it's still hot. That's why I actually have the chicken up on its side. I'm trying to like let it cool off faster. You want to let the meat rest, and it's more tender that way. If I cut it open right now, a lot of the juices just dump out of it. So we're gonna have to cut it here and come back in a few minutes when that's all done. And it is getting hot in here. I gotta air out this kitchen. All right, be right back. All right, moment of truth. It's pretty hot. Not bad. Needs more salt and maybe more of that cheese. But it will taste better actually after like a day or so after it sits in the fridge. The flavor's kind of mellow. Maybe you've noticed that before with some leftovers that you've had. It can sometimes taste better. All right, well, I'm gonna put this stuff in the freezer here when it's cooled off a little bit and clean up the kitchen. But this has been really productive, and I hope you give this recipe a try. I know it has a lot of steps, but it's delicious, it's really healthy. You know, throw some chicken in there, or if you're a vegan, you could put in some legumes and maybe have some protein powder on the side or something. But yeah, I'm really glad that we did this today. So thanks for joining us at Kyle Beyer Nutrition's kitchen. I got a few other batch cooking recipes, and man, it is hot in here. So thanks for watching. Enjoy.